does it look like when somebody comes to work with you? What does that process look like?
So step one is when they come to me, I discuss their goals. I find out exactly what they want to achieve, how much, and by when. So I figure out their deadlines and everything like that. Next, I address their health history. I see if there are any factors that could make it difficult to reach their weight. I then perform a hormonal assessment on them and a digestive assessment.
How do you do a hormonal assessment? That's a blood.
So yes. Okay. So here's what I do. First, I give them a questionnaire that looks for 24 different factors that can actually undermine your weight loss efforts or any other efforts for that matter. And if the results on that questionnaire come back in the high risk category, then I would refer them out to their doctor or to a naturopathic doctor to actually get them tested with either blood or saliva tests. Then I actually tell them if they are
saliva
in that.
Saliva test, you said?
Saliva
test. What
tests.
Does the saliva test do?
So saliva tests are similar to blood tests. Is that it's just that some hormones are indicated more accurately by saliva levels.
I've never heard of that.
Mm-hmm. There are three types of hormonal testing, urine testing, blood testing, and saliva testing. Saliva testing reflects the actual hormone that's in your cells, not in your blood, because not necessarily all the hormones that are in your blood get into your cells. So that actually tests something called bioavailable hormones. Just because you may have testosterone in your blood does not mean it's actually having an effect in your body, okay?
Interesting.
Saliva testing will test for actually testosterone that's actually having an effect on your body,
okay?
So I test for that. If I see any red flags, I would like to work with in conjunction with a naturopathic doctor to address that person's goals. Now, provided they don't have any red flags, so I continue working with them. And the next part of the assessment is musculoskeletal testing. This is like an injury risk assessment. What's interesting about that is it's like taking a look 2, 5, 8, 10 years into the future and seeing where you may get injured. And the encouraging thing about that is that it can be prevented through proper training. Now, a lot of trainers will say a squat is a good exercise, and I agree. A squat is a good exercise, but is it good for everybody all the time? I couldn't say that. There are some people who should not be squatting, or
who?
At least in the assessment, for instance, if I see that they have some knee issues or hip issues or ankle issues, squatting might not be the best thing for them at that time. Okay. Once they get those issues corrected, squatting will again become an effective exercise.
So you kind of do that skeletal, right. muscular testing, and then you can see where the weaknesses are and then design a program to strengthen
based on
all that.
That
stuff, right?
So not only is it an individualized program, so I see exactly what exercises are good for you, not generally good exercises, but good for you at that period in time, and what we can do to actually increase your exercise vocabulary by correcting any imbalances you may have, so preventing any issues down the line. I'll give you something tangible to think about when it comes to this injury risk assessment. Some people walk around with lower back pain for years or decades, but they just take it for granted. They just think it's just part of aging. Not necessarily. If you correct the muscular imbalances that accompany lower back pain or lower back dysfunction, suddenly in the matter of 2, 3, 4 weeks, chronic back pain that they may have had for years or possibly even decades just goes away. So that's the one thing that can happen through this injury risk assessment, and that opens up a whole variety of exercises that before they would have been too high risk for them to do, that now it's just fine. So
that's I mean, there's a lot of people that have chronic back pain that
exactly.
You know, that they would love to get it addressed somehow.
Yeah.
Maybe they've done a lot of stuff and just haven't been able to help. So not only can they maybe deal with that problem, they can mm-hmm. also get fit at the same time.
Exactly. So not only do they come, they might come to me for weight loss, but they get so much more than that. They get decreased risk of injury, little chronic pains, not necessarily in the back, maybe in the shoulder, in the knee, in the hip, suddenly go away. Digestive issues like bloating, constipation, diarrhea, or drowsiness, things that accompany food sometimes just go away entirely. So yes, they get weight loss, but it's a bit more holistic, all encompassing than that. They get their musculoskeletal health taken care of, and they get their digestive health taken care of.
Yeah.
So it's a bit more holistic, as I said.
All right. So pretty much anybody who's got wants to get fit, wants
right.
to maybe lose some weight, maybe
yep.
they got some back pain issues or some other physical issues, if they're working with you, a personal trainer, you do an assessment, figure out
exactly.
what their goals are,
yep.
and just help get them where they want to go.
Bingo.
And do you work in all parts of town, or do you work in certain areas, or?
Okay, so I have my own, not my own gym, but a gym that I rent. It's in Markham, Thornhill.